Daybridge, the Google Calendar Killer.
Well, that's a pretty good SEO, clickbaity, intriguing title. Attaboy, Dimitri. I heard about Daybridge, ironically enough, from Marques Brownlee, who would have thought? And he mentioned it on his podcast, and I was like, what is Daybridge? Is it cool? I mean, it's everything. These calendar apps are like a dime a dozen, right? You got like Morgan, this is good. You got Kron's Google Calendar itself, it's pretty good. What's the best calendar app, right? Like, what is a calendar app? Let's think about that. It's just showing you when you need to be at places or need to be doing things. But Daybridge may be bridging the gap on what's important. It's currently in public beta. It has a mobile app and has a desktop app, and I like it. Let's check it out. It's available on mobile and it's available on Mac/PC just via the web app, as you can see here. So there's a couple different ways you can look at this. Obviously, a little bit overwhelming, a lot of stuff going on, but let's condense things a bit. First and foremost, something that I look at when checking out calendar apps is what are the different options I have for focusing on things, planning, and not really caring too much. And I like the fact that this has a focus feature, which just lets you focus on a short period of time. You can choose day, 3 days, or weekdays, or week. But the key idea here is, as you saw, when I switched to weekdays, it moved me from focus to like sort of the planning view. So the key here is it's actually honing in on just what you have going on for the day. Then when you select something here, it'll show you what calendar it's on. It'll show you like the tag that it has associated to it. So if I right click and press edit, you'll see this is like a little tag that you can associate to all your different things on your calendar, as well as you can change the repeat on here. So I don't have it repeated. It's just an individual block that I made for the day. You can add a location. And I like the way that this app feels. I got to say, it feels pretty good. And the stop repeating option is pretty good. You can do the date or after a certain amount of occurrences. But I really like the fact that when I did every day and switched to every week, it showed me the options for repeat on. That's something that a lot of applications are really annoying about, just don't do. So that was pretty cool. And then the month stopped showing it, the year stopped showing it. It seems to show you the right information contextually when you need it. So when it comes to this, I can change the icon as well, which I actually appreciate. I appreciate the fact that you can associate icons to things, because instead of me having to put an emoji next to all of these, I could just, for example, press this guy and hit edit and change some emoji to video or something, or I guess it's not gonna camera maybe, yeah, camera. And then if I press save, it would apply that to this. And that's a nice little touch for you. You can delete things by pressing this. You can add new events by doing that. So add something new like debate. I like that it doesn't bring up a like calendar block here. It more hones you in on the text, because let's do edit videos. And interestingly enough, if you saw what I did there, it had like natural language processing and understanding that I'm talking about videos. So it's like, is it television? Is it video games? So these are sort of presets that are put in there. So plan week. Let's see what other ones plan. Yep, there's general. You can put admin, meeting. So let's pick one of these. And you'll see that there's a tag on it already. There's general. Change it to hobbies. You can change it to general. And then it asks you to change the time zone. So like 9 to 12. Then let's press save. Now I will say the load time on bringing stuff in does take a second, but that's okay. And then moving these around works pretty well. It's decently fluid with a little bit of delay time on the saving, but the feel of the dragging is nice, and the feel of opening and pressing on it is important. So in my opinion, at least with the calendar app, when you click on it, one of the most main important experiences is when you click on it, what information are you getting? Are you getting the Google Calendar sort of vibe, or are you getting the Morgan vibe? I think Morgan, when you click on it, is probably not my favorite experience. You get a double click to get good information, but I actually like the fact that when you click on this, it highlights it and shows everything over here, which is a better way, in my opinion, to visualize it. You can also share this event very easily by right-clicking it, pressing share event, then you can create a link, create a unique link to share with this event with others. And you could hide this like that. And then when it goes to the relaxed view, it sort of hides the free time between things and showcases it into different chunks like morning, afternoon, and evening. And you can add an event by just pressing that plus sign and it'll start it in that block. And then when it goes to the plan week, this will give you the weekly view and showcase to you different gaps that you have in your schedule so that you can plan accordingly. As you can see, if I go back to today, and just to point out, if I press left or right with my arrow keys, it's gonna go navigate between everything. You can see the different gaps that I have today. So This is essentially bringing in my Google Calendar stuff. So what I'm noticing immediately is that it did not bring in a certain calendar. I do like the fact that I can scroll through calendar like this. I think that's a cool view for you. If I go here to calendars, it should be bringing in my dentist appointment at 12:40, but it does not seem to be, which is a little disconcerting. I see why. That's, I guess, my fault. But if you want to declutter some things and get rid of like the work blocks, for example, you can kind of do that, or you can set certain tags so that it only would show things like this. So for example, personal things. So I got rid of work, all this kind of stuff. It would only show me what's personal. For example, that plan thing that I showed earlier, which is a different way of looking at your life for sure. Just tagging different things like that rather than having to make a bunch of different calendars. And if you don't like this sidebar, you can easily toggle it away. There's also an Android app currently, by the way. There's iOS and Android applications. There's a Slack channel to join a community there. They have a roadmap to showcase, a changelog. And I like the fact that companies do this because when they don't have a monthly view, people are going to request it and then they can put it in there. Apple iCloud support isn't in there. To-dos would be really nice to make it a daily planner app. And you can also see different features, bug reports, and small improvements that they've recently made. Makes it easy for people like me who need to make update videos. And then here, just to add integrations really quickly, it's pretty standard stuff, so I didn't get into it early on. You just press this connect button, connect to something like your Google account, and as that is everyone's pretty much main app of choice, or main email of choice, should be pretty simple. And then you can, by default, enable or disable these, and then change whether they're within your personal life, general, so then they can go into those different sections that I showcased earlier. Daybridge, be doing well. You'd also be doing well as a consumer if you checked out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.